Good morning, students. This is Assistant Professor Namrata Khilochia, Rafael BBA College, Vapi. In today's session, we will be going to discuss about the method of project or network analysis, that is CPM. CPM stands for Critical Path Method. The Critical Path Method is a step-by-step project management technique for process planning that defines critical and non-critical tasks with the goal of preventing time frame problems and process bottlenecks. The CPM is ideally suited to the projects consisting of numerous activities, that means having a project whose nature are complex. So just like PERT, CPM is also useful for complex nature projects. Now, the origin of the CPM. CPM was developed in 1956 at the E.I. DuPont Company, USA. The method reduced shutdown period from 130 hours to 90 hours and also saved the company's $1 million. There are several steps in CPM method. These are divided into 5 phases. Let us discuss this. Step number 1. Define the required task and put them down in a proper sequence. Step number 2. Create a flowchart or other diagram showing each task in relation to the other activities or task. Step number 3. Identify the critical and non-critical relationship or path amongst the tasks. Step number 4. Determine the expected completion time or execution time for each task. Step number 5. Locate or devise alternative or backup for the most critical path. There are certain advantages and disadvantages of CPM method. Let us discuss this. Advantages of CPM. The important advantages of CPM techniques are, first one, it helps in ascertaining the time schedule of activities having sequential relationship with each other. Second, it makes control easier or understand for the management. Advantage number 3, that is, it makes better and detailed planning possible. Advantage number 4, that is, it provides standard method for communicating project plans, schedules, time, and performance. Now, limitation of CPM. The main limitation of the CPM are, first one, CPM operates on the assumption that there is a precise known time that each activity in the project will take. But in reality, it may not be true. Second, CPM time estimates are not based on statistical analysis or proven methods. Third, it cannot be used as controlling device for the simple reason that any changes introduced will change the entire structure of network diagram. In other words, CPM cannot be used as a dynamic controlling device. So, here we are clear with the basic concept of CPM. Thank you, students.